Thanks, Chris.
Thanks for coming.
That song was entitled Mindfulness. It's one that I've always really enjoyed humming, and I love to hear these guys play it. And I've also played it in another situation where it was kind of had like a backbeat, sort of a fusion, same sort of vibe. I really, really enjoyed it. But it's one of those tunes speaking along the lines of mindfulness, of being mindful of each other, being mindful of everyone that you encounter, being mindful of our friends, our family, our partners, our spouses, being mindful of everything, being mindful of life always. And that was something that I was thinking about and feeling and dealing with, and I put it into this particular song, and that's mindfulness. I hope you guys enjoyed that one. We're going to move on to a composition. Thank you. Thank you, guys. Thank you very much. We're going to move on to a composition now that's going to be the name of the album that I'm working on. All of this music is coming from this particular album. This record, my debut record, is going to be entitled The Water. And one of the reasons why I... Well, when you see the album cover, you kind of realize some of the imagery that goes along with it. And the water represents the aspect of... I want to say that the aspect of our ancestors and those that have come before us, the ones that have paved the way for us to be here where we are and where we are in our lives. And it was a memento to all of those that had gone on, my family, my friends, everyone that I've ever known. But the water signified, you know, where I grew up in North Carolina, the baptisms were very huge within the spiritual and religious sect of cleansing, almost of it in a sense. And you know, the way that my parents, my whole family, you know, how I grew up, talked about the water, it always signified a cleansing of sorts, or sort of a renewal. And that's where I got a lot of this aspect of dealing with the water. And also, I'm a Cancer, so I deal with it elementally, and I'm, you know, that's something I really wanted to write about. So this composition is entitled The Water. Thank you.
so much. That composition, like I said, was entitled The Water. Very near and dear composition. All of these are very near and dear, for sure. We're going to change pace just a little bit, and we're going to play the third of my compositions for this evening. This song is entitled This Prayer. And I'm not going to talk too much about it. I'm sure that you guys can see a lot of the imagery of the titles and the songs and the meditations that I'm kind of writing. So this one is called This Prayer.
Thank you.
This prayer, a song I've enjoyed listening to and playing in a couple of different situations, but this has got to be one of my favorites. Listening to these wonderful gentlemen and wonderful friends. How about a round of applause again for Denny Abel on the guitar, Sam Taylor on tenor saxophone, Oscar Rossignoli on the piano. Moving on to this next composition, you guys will have fun with it. How many of you guys are movie buffs? How many of you guys are fans of... Yeah, here we go, okay. Well, you might actually dig how this concept came about, because it's not really that deep. My girlfriend and I were watching the DC comic Hellboy, and it's actually the second one. And there was a spot in the beginning where Professor Broom or whatever is telling the story. And the way that this came about was it was a very sort of interesting concept where he was talking about the land of mystical creatures and, you know, the spirits of the forest and yada, yada, yada. And he said it was, what was it, under the time of the rule of Aglan the Father Tree, I believe. Was that what it was, baby? And the fact was that it was a very interesting concept because we hear so much about like Mother Nature and you know, the mothering spirit. And it just, like I said, it was just something that was very interesting. It just caught me off guard. Eglin, the father tree. And all of the spirits in the spirit, not only in the spirit world, but like goblins and everything, the mystical creatures, they lived under the protection of Eglin, the father tree. And I thought about that. And I said, wow, that sounds like a tune. You know, I should really actually try to expand on this. So this is a song that I call Eglin the Father Tree. I hope you guys enjoy this one. Thank you. definitely one of the fun tunes that we have. Always a joy to play that one, always a joy to listen to it, and it's definitely finally coming more so around with some different instruments, you know, different instrumentation. There's a lot of things that can be added to that. You know, when in working on the record, there was chamber ensemble string parts that were inside of that, a lot of through composition that were in, that was inside of that song. So there's a lot more to come. There's a lot more writing that you guys will hear on the record. We are going to sort of switch gears from some of the jazz, straight ahead, even eighth sort of sound, and I'm going to go towards some music of my home state of North Carolina. This is a song that I wrote many, many years ago, and it was in the process of thinking of my mom. And I think one day, like, my mom smiled, and this composition just kind of came. I think I was leaving the house or something like that, and sat down and started playing it, or playing the progression to it, and it just seemed to just keep, you know, just like many of my other compositions, they just kind of keep, you know, I sing them, I hum them. I'm not a vocalist by any means, but I sing and I hum them to myself and kind of play them through, and this sort of sound just kind of resembles, I think, that occasion where my mom happened to do that. And so this is signifying, you know, necessarily my mother's smile. This is simply entitled Smile. Thank you. Thank you, guys. Thank you for checking that one out. All right, staying along some of the path that we were taking with some of the straight ahead jazz, we're going to move into back to the element of kind of like the first song. This next composition that I wrote is entitled Shift, and just a little bit of backstory about it. I actually wrote this composition as a what's called a free or guided rubato song, and it had four phrases to it. I didn't think very much of it. Really just kind of wanted to write in the free sense, see what, but I never performed it. And when I did a record recording project, a friend of mine asked me to bring a song in, and I thought, oh man, okay, I'll bring a couple in. I had these up songs, I had these, and I was getting ready for one of my first recordings, and I said, man, I need like an up-tempo song. I kind of, you know, need to dabble into, you know, some of these kind of come. So I took this rubato song that I had, and I actually I changed it into an up-tempo swing. And I'm not even going to tell you guys to try and count this. I have to tell you that I get lost. I don't want to say we get lost collectively because I can't blame it on these guys. It's usually me. I'm playing some sort of sense of something on it. But it's entitled Shift, and it's just about simply these four phrases that you'll sort of hear, and systematically they get changed within different metric complexes, you know, within the song or whatever. So you'll hear the harmonic text in it, you'll hear some of the things that are going on. It does swing, but it's just simply entitled Shift. So I hope you guys enjoy this composition. shift. It's always exciting. Most of the time I play it too fast, actually. These guys kind of eye me. I say, like, Steve, what are you doing? We're going to actually shift gears just a little bit. We're going to play sort of a mantric meditation. This one is entitled Psalm. And I believe that you'll find this to be sort of a very simple composition. But I hope that you guys will love this one as much as I do. Again, another composition that seems to just kind of have that sort of effect, that it's one that came just from singing and humming it and giving it to these guys. And there's still a lot more, you know, and aspects that can go on top of it through composition things. But this is entitled Song.
Thank you.
ladies and gentlemen, Sam Taylor on the tenor saxophone. Danny Abel on the guitar. My friend Oscar Rossignoli on the piano and keyboards. Lex Warshawsky on the acoustic and electric bass. My name is Stephen Gordon on the drums. Thank you so much for thank you very much. Thank you for hanging out and listening to some of my compositions and the ability to bring these compositions to life. I greatly thank you guys for being here and being in this energy with us. It makes my heart full of gratitude and full of joy that you would share your time with us. This last composition that we're abbreviating here is called Giving Thanks. And we thank all of you for being a part of this journey and my journey writing this music. And thank you so much for supporting this music and Music Always, this beautiful city series that Jazz and Heritage has. So we're going to close out the night with this song entitled Giving Thanks. And we give thanks to you guys. Thank you always and have a great night. Thank you, guys. Have a great evening. Take care.